sunshine break through the National Capital Region, but we go at sunshine temperatures today in the 70s.
We'll take any sunshine we can get. Thank you, Clay. All right, we're going to remind you, you get the latest news and weather anytime with our NBC Washington app. For now, back to Sunday Today.
I'm not going to announce my VP pick just yet. In many ways, it will be determined by the winner of the Jake Paul Mike Tyson fight. So we
That is James Austin Johnson as former President Trump on last night's season 49 finale of Saturday Night Live. Chip Gyllenhaal hosted the show with musical guest Sabrina Carpenter. At this time, 2 years ago, Glen Powell's life was about to change with the release of Top Gun Maverick. Powell first auditioned for the role of Rooster, which went to Miles Teller, but Tom Cruise convinced him to play the hotshot pilot Hangman. Top Gun went on to make nearly $1.5 billion at the box office, making Powell a star around the world. Then he and Sydney Sweeney teamed up for the romantic comedy Anyone But You, which did $220 million worth of business. Powell arriving on Hollywood's A-list after a long, steady career that began more than two decades ago with Spy Kids 3D. Glenn and I got together in New York the other day for a Sunday sit-down where we were joined by his rescue puppy, Frisket.
I'm happy to see you. I'm really puppy.
Yeah, I'm getting used to that. This is the true wingman on every corner of the planet.
Glenn Powell knows a thing or two about being a wingman.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is your senior speaker.
That breakout performance as a swaggering fighter pilot in the 2022 summer blockbuster Top Gun Maverick sent Powell's career into a steep climb. Now the 35-year-old has landed in the film Hitman, a passion project he co-wrote, co-produced, and stars in.
How many do you think you know yourselves?
Your fingerprints are all over it, from co-writing to co-producing to starring in it. Does that change your experience as an actor in the movie?
I did have a little bit of a moment of panic right before we started, and I was like, did I write something that I can't pull off? When you have a collaborator that you can talk with and get into the trenches with, none of those conversations are scary.
Powell collaborated on Hitman with one of his heroes, famed director Richard Linklater, the man behind movies like Dazed and Confused, Boyhood, and the Before trilogy.
It must say to you a lot about where you've come in your career that the great Richard Linklater said, I wanted you to be my peer on this.
Yeah.
I don't just want you to be in my film. Let's write this together. Help me produce this.
I get to, like, literally be on set with Richard Linklater on something we cooked up together and look at him eye to eye as a collaborator and friend.
Congrats, Gary. You just got promoted to contract killer.
Well, were you rescheduled?
Powell plays Gary Johnson, a college professor who moonlights for his local police department, going undercover as a decoy hitman. The film is based loosely on the real Gary Johnson, who Powell discovered while reading an article in Texas Monthly magazine.
What about it told you, well, I think there's a movie in here.
Immediately, I was like, oh, this is a fascinating character. He would psychoanalyze you and figure out what your fantasy of a hitman was. So they called him the Lawrence Olivier fake hitman, but he just put on all these identities and characters, and he feels like he's embracing humanity in a way that he can't when he's Gary. And I started thinking about how we all do that. You go to a costume party, you put on a different outfit, a different personality comes out. And I feel like that's what makes this movie really universal, is people can look at us and assume one thing, but we all contain multitudes. We all contain all these different things that are exciting and things that we want people to see and express.
Leading man success hardly has been overnight for Powell, who grew up in Austin, Texas, playing sports with an occasional acting gig mixed in.
But I'm like, danger dude, gosh.
Casting agents in Hollywood could not resist you after they saw tape of Danger Dune. I think that's really what put you over the top, right?
Why were you watching Danger
Dune? I'm digging deep, digging deep.
That's the most impressive journalism I've seen in my entire life.
Oh, fine.
I did this internet safety video called The Safe Side, where I played this character named Danger Dude, which is basically like a Napoleon Dynamite knockoff.
It was like an impersonation.
We all got our start somewhere. Danger Dude, I love that you bring it up.
Still a high school senior, Powell made the natural leap from playing Danger Dude to appearing with Denzel Washington in the 2007 film, The Great Debaters.
Nonviolence is the mask civil disobedience wears to conceal its true face.
Denzel Washington really pushed me out of the nest a bit and said, you should double down on yourself, you should give this a shot.
And if Denzel Washington tells you you're good at something, that's probably a good sign.
Oh my God.
Yeah, especially like a 17-year-old kid. I was like,
he's like high school, right.
Yeah. You know, I've seen him since. He's like, you owe me.
After a year of college, Powell chased his dream to Los Angeles, where the next decade or so was a slow burn of supporting roles in movies and on TV, before Top Gun and last year's box office sensation Anyone But You, co-starring Sydney Sweeney, made him a bona fide star.
And you two really are getting to know each other in a very respectful manner. One befitting such a kind and intelligent woman as your daughter.
I thought romantic comedies weren't supposed to work anymore. Did you guys come along? Could you have imagined what it became?
What I'm really proud of on Anyone But You is that Sydney and I took a gamble that people would pay their $15, leave the house, get the sitter, whatever it means, to show up to the theater for a movie that's just about love.
So how many rom-com scripts did you get the Monday after opening weekend?
Like, whatever you want, please,
totally.
You know, Sydney and I want to get back in the trenches together on all of it. And it's like Julia and George, you know, Matthew and Kate, you know, these people that work together over and over and over again. It's when you find somebody that you have a great creative partnership with and somebody you can really trust, you want to just keep doing that. There's no reason to do it in any other way.
So more coming from the two of you?
Yeah, my agent's gonna hate me for saying this, but we are reading. We are.
It was fun.
Stupid, but fun.
Oh,
that's good. So you saved the romantic comedy. Thank you for that. And the year before that, you guys saved theatrical movies altogether.
Yeah.
With Top Gun, Maverick.
Yeah, yeah.
So thank you for that as well.
You're welcome.
I am good at rooster. I'm very good.
Tom gave me his great advice when I was sort of waffling on if I was going to do Top Gun at all. He was relentless. He really invited me into the process, and that's how Tom works. It's like, it's a team sport. It's a living, breathing organism where you're all kind of contributing ideas. But yeah, that movie really changed my life in so many ways, but really, I think it was a signal of a new chapter in my life and ownership over that new chapter.
A new chapter for Glen Powell that has been worth the wait.
You have to just continue to tell yourself that you're sort of the underdog in the story, and eventually it's going to lead to a big game, you know,
and makes where you're sitting right now all the sweeter.
100%. I think that's where I'm really taking in this moment right now, which is I've always kind of just kept my head down and you just kind of keep at it, and now I'm getting to sit down with people like you and really talk about this stuff in a way that's, it's been really amazing and surreal.
Hitman will be in select theaters this Friday, May 24th, and on Netflix, June 7th. Glen also is the producer, along with J.J. Abrams, of the stunning IMAX documentary, The Blue Angels, about the famed Navy pilots in theaters now. And his big-budget disaster movie, Twisters, is out in July. I told you he's in demand. Our thanks to Primos in New York for hosting our conversation. Don't forget to subscribe to the Sunday Sit Down podcast to hear the full extended interview with Glen Powell. Much more in there for you. You can find that on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get yours. And next week, on Memorial Day weekend, we kick off the summer with one of our favorites, Darius Rucker, on his path from playing college bars to leading one of the biggest bands in the world, and then finding chart-topping success again in country music. Darius Rucker, next week on Sunday Today. Let's turn now and get another quick check of your local Sunday weather.
Hi everybody, meteorologist Clay Anderson. Looking at some sunshine to the west we are, and Reston, Virginia, as the low clouds continue to dissipate across the Washington Capital region. Temperatures are warming up gradually, but they are warming up 65 degrees at our nation's capital, 62 degrees with clouds still in Ocean City. If you're thinking about that early brunch today, well, think about it. It shouldn't be too bad. Temperatures will be warming up into the mid-70s, and all of us will see some sunshine. Everyone enjoy your Sunday. Today.
Ahead on Sunday Today, our highs and lows of the week, including the story behind this driveway mural of a boat. One its clever way around a city ordinance. But next, our Sunday spotlight on the 50th anniversary of People Magazine, documenting a half century of American pop culture.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Field.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomorrow on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye bye.
So anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh no, we have 3,
2, 1.
Bye.